let's get this game on the screen. All right, round three, and then you guys are off to the races. This is our undefeated here. Nicola on top. Versus Morel. So we got a Draco mirror here. The old Lockhart's hair care. Is this three Dracos and a Lucius? Is that what's going on this week? You make one comment about action advantage and everybody just loses their minds. No, I'm just kidding. Really though, I think it's smart by all these players. I see every single deck this week is something we hadn't seen in the past weeks. Every single deck this week has some kind of way to take advantage of action advantage, give themselves more actions, more to do, do more with less. All of those are really, really powerful. It's how you win at this game, taking more actions than your opponent. Well, more relevant actions, right? All right, both of these guys are just kind of in a race to get set up. We see the magical me coming down for Frizz. We know that that's part of that big healing loop that he does. But he's seeing his opponent kind of having some of the same ideas. The Snape is already down, so the character war is going to be pretty real between these guys. Nicola is getting access to Arthur Weasley first, so that's pretty strong. I don't know if Morel is playing Arthur, but Morel is going to respond by taking Snape off the table. For Nicola, and I think that both these guys are going to get a decent half of the wishbone here, but the Arthur Weasley probably going to come out on top. The extra healing is going to be big for Morel, but I think that Nicola is going to be doing just fine on healing between the Pomfrey that he's main listing and also the fact that he has those the silver unicorn horn. Sorry, I almost called it silver dragon horn, not quite, huh? But we do have here for Morel, we have the Holidays with Hags. We saw that earlier, kind of lets you just slam two lessons in. It does actually end up being acceleration if you're playing it with Draco. Then Lucius is Kane as well. This is a unique card. So the cool thing about this is it doesn't follow the same rule as the characters. Actually, does it? Unique Kane? I think it does actually, right? Unique. Is that only for your witches and wizards? We've got the two Magical Me books down. So yeah, I mean, that is what unique means. So the cane is going to be an interesting pickup here. Only one of them can have the cane out at a time. So, I mean, it is Lucius's cane, right? Only one of them exists. Seamus Finnegan also coming down against Nicola here. So this is a lot of the cards that we saw on Nicola's side of the field in the games where he won getting played against him here. So interesting. I wonder if he will he'll be able to loop his healing cards better. Although we see, it looks like our opponent's doing the same thing. I mean, I see an Ollivander's here. I'd be shocked if we didn't have the Unicorn Horn or some similar healing style that we were looping with the Ollivander's. And of course, Unicorn Horn is going to come down for our opponent. I wish that that was a unique card, because that'd be kind of cool to see the battle over that. But I think that actually, even though the Lucius... so that's unique. Kane's unique. Oh, he's discarding it. Silver Unicorn Horns, putting them back in the deck. Okay, that's pretty cool. Well, the sickle pops, which means that we get a bunch of extra actions. We're gonna slam. Quarrel is gonna come down. We're gonna use Quarrel. Really, that's gonna return all items to the player's hand. So it's gonna put the book back in our hand. It's gonna put the cane back in our hand. It will let us kind of re-dip into that Malfoy action advantage. We're gonna play the cane, and of course, again, get that action back. We can discard two cards to get Seamus action. So we're really just we're kind of getting extra power out of our cane here this turn. Oh baby, we have a self-stirring cauldron in hand too. All right, so we actually have to count. So sickle put us up to four actions, then we played Quarrel for two, we used Quarrel, bounces back to our hand, then we played the cane, that was neutral, so we played it was our third spent action, but we got it back. Then we played self-stirring cauldron, which is our fourth spent action, but we got it back, so we still have two actions. So we played sickle, so now we still have one action. And that was our fifth played action. We still have one to go. When we play our sixth action here, we'll be doing 8 damage for our opponent. And there it is. We used our last action to draw a card, and that's 8 damage to Nicola from the cane. And that is a hefty sum. We're blocking the Snape here, but we aren't blocking the Ollivander's Dragon Horn. Sorry, Unicorn Horn. Why do I keep doing that? We're gonna have to make a Dragon Horn card. The Unicorn Horn loop. And we also can't stop the Pomfrey. Can't stop the Pomfrey. But probably gonna be taking advantage more of the horns. Yeah, so it looks like we're gonna just put two Christmas Feasts back into the deck. Of course, Christmas Feast is gonna be another way to just keep cycling those horns and the Magical Mies so that we can keep getting Ollivanders, so that we can keep getting the horns. Yada, 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 yada. The healing loop. Speaking of the loop, Ollivander is going to get played here by Morel. Ollivander is going to go and get back. Nope, that's not how that works. Doing, hold up. Oh wait, never mind. Ollivander's. I'm sorry. I was thinking of the magical me that gets. Ollivander's definitely gets sickle. Doy. Magical me is the one that's only 2 or less. Yeah. So we get the sickle. We play that. That refunds us another action. We get holidays with hags. Play a lesson. Only one extra action so far. Are we gonna pass there and only deal 2 damage, or are we gonna go for it with Seamus? I say we go for it. Discard 2 into Seamus, use an action to draw a card, and just deal an extra 2 damage. Basically, would you discard a card from your hand right now to deal 2 damage to your opponent? Yeah, I would. Oh, put that cane right in the discard pile. I think it's interesting that Nicole is even healing the canes, considering one's already in play, and I don't think Nicola has a way to remove it, but I don't 100% remember the list from the first games. We are going to take six there. That's going to be from our opponents. Oh, wait. Oh, never mind. He's healing it again. I always think he's playing the cane. we used Arthur to deal. Imagine three. We're healing with the unicorn horn here. What are we doing with all the... Yeah, again, I think putting the cane back in is interesting. Because we can't play it. Well, we'll see. We'll draw a card. Oh boy, what? Who? Dobby? Oh my goodness, we played Dobby. Dobby, another revival card. So again, Dobby is going to be during each opponent's turn. You may prevent up to 4 damage done to you. If any damage is prevented in this way, at the end of that turn, the opponent may choose a non-healing card in play other than Dobby and return it to its owner's hand. This is wild to me that we would play this. Because our opponent's just going to be dealing damage. I guess it's up to you whether or not you prevent it. But heck yeah. Please trigger this. I'd love to return Seamus or some of these permanents to your hand. Self-stirring Cauldron actually would be another great one to return to your hand because you just discarded two more potions lessons. Excuse me. So we're going to play Nearly Headless Nick, looks like. He's coming in here. He's upside down. That's okay. Poor Nick. That poor guy. He's upside down. There we go. He's going to look in the card. Or he's looking for two items in the main deck, actually. Going to go ahead and slap two items into our hand. Magical Me Book and... Holidays with Hags. Yep, nothing wrong with those. Those are just more items that also count as lessons for us. Basically more free action, quote unquote, things to make sure that we're always triggering the cane every turn. And that's going to be 8 from those. The cauldron really helps you get those extra actions. It's going to be 8 to deck. You can't play the cane. Can't play the cane. Can't play the cane. Maybe they're chatting about it. Oh, my message. If I see them take another action, I'll pop into it. Yeah, so since Lucius with Cain is unique, we can't play one. The other side of the table. All right, there we go. Yeah, he made the proper judge call. I love that. I love that. Shout out. We actually asked in the judge calls channel, does unique apply to both sides? And the answer is yes. Just like the character card rule. I think that Kane might be one of the only... I mean, there aren't too many of them. I think that the Philosopher's Stone is another one. But it's one of the only cards that is unique that isn't a character. But yeah, it's one of the cool things about this game is that the game, like... even if you have different versions of a character... So let's say you have Draco Malfoy Slytherin here. And there's also, like, Draco the Seeker. And there's also just Draco Malfoy. The game knows that all three of those are the same guy. They know that it's Draco, no matter what you're calling him. So there can't be two Dracos on the table. It's different than a lot of other games that way, but it's cool because it gives like the characters and the cards themselves almost like an identity. And it makes them more important, just like they are in the books and in the stories. So I think that that's really neat. We're gonna slam a sickle down here, jam of potions out as well. Boy, we are riding down on all items here, but I mean, we're post Quirrell. We have a Quirrell out, so we've locked our opponent out of one. Not that I think that there's one in Nicola's deck, but you know, we've basically protected ourselves from Quirrell by playing it and using it first, right? So you've got these cauldrons and the books. Everything here is just pumping value. Like, they're all lessons without being lessons, right? I mean, if these are in play, are these in place? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, plus 13, 14. We're up to 14 power. I mean, is there even anything we can do with all that? I mean, we're trying to just take extra lessons and cane our opponent down, right? But we're just stacking. We're both just stacking magical Mii's so that we can keep getting all of Edders and keep getting the healing cards. Pretty funny. Can I even look at this? Didn't want to look at his discard pile. Just stack them up. Yeah, so we're healing 7 with Snape to try and stay ahead of Nicola here. Now I imagine Nicola's gonna immediately cast one of these magical Mii's in for an Ollivander's to get back a horn if we haven't already done that, and just start looping that healing back, kind of a call and response. Now, we have the Arthur Weasley down. Even though our opponent took the Kane, remember last time how we were talking about how the Kane was our only win condition left when they took our Arthur. So those are the two ways that we can win. So the Arthur is out. So we lost the Kane. We have Arthur. We have to lean into Arthur, which means we need to get just the Unicorn Horns. So we need to play the Unicorn Horn, have the action, heal the damage while it's out, and then use it to heal. Our best bet. So it looks like we are going to crack a Magical Mii to get Unicorn. Well, I mean, I guess we're just shortcutting, right? We're going to say Magical Mii for Ollivanders, play the Ollivanders, get the Unicorn. Basically, Magical Mii turns into the Unicorn Horn. Unicorn Horn is going to put two Christmas Feasts back right back into the deck. Then we're going to deal... So we use the Magical Mii. That costs an action, right? Doesn't it? No, but playing the Ollivanders costs the action. So this is like 1 to get it back, 2 to play it, and it refunds the action for us. Are we going to sit on 10? Oh boy, are we just going to hit him with the The Arthur? For how many? I can't tell. I think we did. I think we're just sitting on 10 and giving him the turn here. Oh man, that's scary. Oh boy, alright, so we're healing up. We did survive. Yeah, this is good. This is scary. So basically, we're only able to do so much because we don't have any of the action generating stuff besides Seamus, right? So we got a certain number of actions, we cashed them in. We did enough damage that, you know, Nicola got one more turn, but it wasn't enough. So we see that we can't win it there, and we scoop it and go into game two. Really, really crazy game there. I think just barely taking it is going to be morale, and it's because Morale had certain characters down. The Seamus, putting him ahead, all those actions, big deal. Getting the cane down, and the fact that the cane was unique. Also because, and I feel a little bit for him, I don't think that we realized that the unique cane was, like, that we wouldn't be able to play the cane, because we saw a couple times that Nicola went and put that back into the deck to try and get access to it. You know, like, I think on two or three of the heals, we put the cane back in, thinking, like, okay, we really want to get to that damage. So the fact that they're both playing the cane is getting in the way for sure. Maybe we would have invested a little bit more into Arthur damage if we realized that was kind of all we had. In fact, I'm sure we would have. So we'll see how that comes out here in the next one. But oh my goodness, the results are in. They went real fast. At the other table, they're already done. I said they're fast. He says bludgers are, but I think the bludgers are actually super slow. They do start doing damage quick once they start doing damage, though. Man, creatures are the kill shot, though. Those are fast. Bludgers will get you there once they start adding up, though. Because the first one happens and you figure it's like 3 damage a turn. You're like, whatever. What's 3 damage a turn? And the second one comes down, you're like, 6 damage a turn. You're like, oh man, that's actually, I can't really ignore 6. That's pretty tough. Then the third one, you're like, 9 damage a turn is like, I have 2 turns left at that point, you know? Like, oops, maybe I had to figure out something about this earlier. All right, so, oh baby, we're hitting the perfect, again, popping off with Draco on Morel's side of the field. We hit the hair care into hair care potion, sorry, potion hair care Nick. Nick, search the deck. We're gonna go get Nut, and we're deciding on the second search. It looks like self-stirring cauldron. Not bad at all. That hair care potion is actually gonna put us in a really good position to get the characters down faster than Nicola too. Nicola doesn't hate lesson and book, but you're looking for something more when you see how your opponent's opening right now. You really, really want to beat him to one of the pieces. You did get the four lessons first, so maybe you can just drop the cane right now and hope that you keep it. But you are aware that your opponent is running the quarrel now. You have that knowledge. We are going to get that Pomfrey down this game. So we play the nut, we play Pomfrey. Samus comes down. And we get the nut into play. We're gonna discard two for the Seamus there. I'd hope so. I mean, we used an action to draw a card just now, right? Wow! I cannot imagine a world where we discard the self-stirring cauldron. We must have two more self-stirring cauldrons in our hand. Or at least one more, I guess. Maybe we don't have to. Oof. I don't know. Not the worst. So we're going to start the turn for Nicola here by playing Ollivander's, getting back the nut, playing nut, getting back the action, and using that third action to draw a card from our deck. Man, a lot of actions to draw cards from the deck here. Slow, slow play. Slow, slow play. Looks like we're going to slam down the Magical Me and Lucius Kane. Get into the Kane first. So we got Seamus out first. We got the Kane out first. And we're on track to get an Arthur. I mean, yeah, Nicola has more cards in his hand, but the hair care potions is going to make playing Arthur much less of an out-of-our-way thing for us here. You really wish that you'd gotten down the Arthur instead of the Madame Pomfrey earlier. And yes, we did have the Cauldron, so we're going to play it here. We're going to bounce those potions, cauldron, and the cauldron cane book charms puts us up to 7. We're pretty much sitting pretty. Looks like we're gonna crack the Holidays with Hags to put 2 potions lessons back into play. I actually like how Holidays with Hags breaks itself to basically set up the next self-stirring cauldron. That's pretty neat. So we're building now. So we cracked the nut. Then we played one from our hand, got that action back. Then we played potion. Yeah, so that we cracked the nut at the beginning of our turn, so we had 3 actions. So we played a nut and got the action back, so we stayed at 3 actions. We played potions, unicorn horn. So we have the Unicorn Horn, we have Ollivander's in the discard pile, we have Magical Me on the field, and Pomfrey is here. The loop is pretty much all the groundwork has been laid. So we really need to get to Arthur, like we need it so bad. If we don't get to Arthur, I think we might be shut out here. If our opponent has both the Kane and Arthur, I don't know how we win. Another self-stirring cauldron here. Burrell, putting him way up there. I mean, this is, we're talking 11. Get Hollers with Hags into play. So Nicola gets the sickle down, and there he is, Arthur. Perfect. Oh boy, did we need that. So the sickle too is gonna let us use Arthur to deal that seven, but it looks like we had no way to get ourselves that action back because Arthur cost two. Thankfully he will be able to, you know, do that unicorn horn damage. Oh no! Quirrell is gonna see some serious damage. Although the Quirrell is gonna walk us back a ton of lessons. We're actually not using the cauldrons to do much, so we don't care. We'd rather just like replay them and get the double action out of them. So it looks like we're gonna use an action on Morel's side to crack the Holidays with Hags to get the two potions in play, because we know we're doing the Quirrell stuff. Then we use our next two actions to do Quirrell. If we use Quirrell, it puts hair care potion. Sorry, we only use one action to do Quirrell. If we use him, it puts hair care potions, two cauldrons, and the cane in our hand. And we bounce our opponent's unicorn horn, sickle, and magical meat. The benefit there is that we take away two lessons for our opponent. We make sure they don't get all those extra actions next turn, and we get rid of the unicorn horn. But I think we actually walk ourselves back way more, because we're forced to play the cane so our opponent can't get to the cane, right? But we don't have enough lessons to play the cane. So it's like, all right, we have to play one of the cauldrons. So then we play the cauldron, we play the cane. That would be our turn. And we would have given him back. He gets another ETB on the unicorn horn to heal two more for free. He'd be happy to play the sickle because, again, he gets the action back. And he would be able to deal seven with Arthur, which he missed last turn. So we actually opt not to Quirrell there. And now that you're Nicola and you see Quirrell is down, what you do is, I just don't think you're going to invest in too many more items on the board. You're just going to kind of use what you have here while you have it. So we see the, it looks like we played a sickle and a Neville. Interesting. Maybe we played the sickle to try and force the Quirrell, but... Wait, what did we just... Oh, we used Arthur to deal damage, and then I think we were going to use the Unicorn Horn, and then we decided not to. We put it back in play, and instead used the action to draw a card. Okay. I think that we're just figuring we would rather have the Unicorn Horn out when he Quirrells, because then not only are we going to get that six healing, but we're going to get the two again for free when it comes in. So that's exactly what's going to happen. We got him to use the Quirrell, so sickle, both of the books that are going to go back to the hand. He loses both cauldrons and the cane. He's going to play a cauldron immediately, get rid of two of those lessons, and then drop the cane for sure. But the big thing about this is, so we started the turn with Quirrell, but didn't cost any actions. Then we played the cauldron, and not only does the cauldron kick back our lesson because of its own effect, but it kicks it back. Sorry, not kick back a lesson, kick back an action. But it also kicks back an action because of Draco, so it's minus one. So we actually go up to three when we play the cauldron. Then we're going to play prancing enchantments here, search for a character. It'll bring us down to two, and then we're going to slam that character into play. Probably going to be Snape. I say Snape because Nick, Quirrell, and Seamus are already out, and our opponent has Pomfrey and Weasley. So I would imagine it's... And we're going to deal 4 damage with the cane because we took 2 extra actions that turn and passed the turn. Now it's Nicole's turn. We're going to slam Magical Me, bounce back that free action because of the Draco effect. We're going to jam down the Unicorn Horn. We're going to heal 2 into the deck, and then we're going to use our third action to have Arthur Weasley deal 6 damage with the Unicorn Horn. And I think that we're realizing that the Quirrell was fine. The Quirrell actually did more to hurt our opponent than it did to hurt us. We got to use the ETB again on the horn, and really the big thing that we had invested in that they can't remove are the characters. So we played Dobby again. It just... Oof, I don't agree. Disagree with the Dobby play. I mean, if you use Dobby to prevent damage right here, and he has the cane in his hand, he just returns your cane and then plays his own cane. And, like, you're SOL. Because the way Dobby's works is Dobby prevents up to 4 damage a turn, but if you ever use it to prevent damage that way, at the end of your turn, the opponent can choose... I guess it happens at the end of the turn. So they can jam down his own cane, he gives you a chance. But what he can do is he can get rid of your Seamus Finnegan. You can get rid of yourself during cauldron, and you don't have that second potion lesson now. You only have 2 cards in hand. He just starts resetting your actions. I don't know. Yeah, of course. So he uses Weasley to sickle damage him. We block 4 of it with Dobby, and then we're like, all right, I'll just put Seamus back in your hand. Go ahead. Okay, so now he Ollivanders and he gets Sickle and he plays the Sickle. Sure. Right now, next turn, we hit him again, and if he prevents any damage to Dobby, we just put the Sickle back in his hand. He did have another potion lesson in hand. Okay, that's good. A little defense against your cauldron getting returned. Only dealing 2 damage with the cane. Sickle trips on Nicola's side. So we're going to have 4 actions turn starting off. We're going to go ahead and use Hannah Abbott. Again, that's not an action. Hannah's going to go and get 2 cards and trade them from our hand. Looks like we were trading Hair Care Potion and Arthur Weasley. We're going to go ahead and get ourselves Impersonating Goyle. I love Impersonating Goyle. I don't know why we would get the... I really don't think we need to Dobby. But we're gonna get Sickle as well, that's fine. So immediately, please don't remove Dobby before you bounce the Sickle for free. No, don't. Oh my god, why would you do that? Could have taken away all these actions he's about to have. I mean, I guess his actions are going to do too much, but he's going to heal. He's going to magical me. He's going to get the thing. He's going to heal. He's going to do all this stuff. I guess we're just trying to like rush him down at this point. You know, so we have Arthur kind of doing his thing. Doing the big damage because of Sickle, doing 7 damage to the opponent here. Gonna go ahead and crack magical me for Ollivanders, get Sickle, put it into play, jam holidays with hags down into play. That's 2 out of 3 actions so far. Oh sorry, no, we used Ollivanders, so that's 3 actions. 1, I guess we did oh no, sorry, I read that wrong. 6. I don't know what happened, but we decided here. So I know that we moved Pomfrey up and we moved Hannah over. Maybe we were talking about those cards a bit. We might have been saying, like, yeah, you got me. I can't stop the 7 damage twice kind of thing. They might have been realizing that there isn't much time left in the round and to kind of just scoop and get to some kind of a game 3. It's probably going to try and... I don't know if it's possible for them to do a game in 6 minutes, but they're probably going to try and jam it out pretty quick here. Lockhart's hair care. Oh, it's a pretty good start. Hair care, potion, nearly headless Nick. Sorry, in the complete opposite order. So potion first, then hair care. Not complete opposite, but whatever. Then nearly hit this Nick. Go and get two items out of our deck. I imagine it's going to be probably self-stirring and or... No. It's going to be a book. It's going to be a book and it's going to be a nut. Magical me and maybe the other book, actually. Yep. Book. Real nerd going to the library here. Nothing wrong with that. All right, pass the turn. He says, yeah, sure, in the Discord when I said it, like, yeah, we know, but I mean, I don't know, they didn't respond to me when I said it in Untap, so I don't know if they knew whether or not. I gave him the old warning there. Into play. Looks like we're going to be discarding hair care and self-stirring cauldron, getting an action back. Ooh, what do we jam here? Another self-stirring? Oh, maybe. Okay, yeah, there we go. I was going to say, wait, what's that self-stirring cauldron doing there? Alright, and we're using actions to draw cards. Oh, looks like we're kicking it over to Nicola. We're going to go ahead and ditch the card there, gain an action. Jamming the holidays with hags. Jamming the self-stirring cauldron. And the cane. Alright, so this guy got to the cane first. We'll have to see if Frizz can get to the Arthur. Otherwise, I think that if Morel is able to establish Arthur and the cane, I think that's like a GG, right? I think we can safely do the gentlemanly scoop at that point. Both of us are just jamming down some self-stirring cauldrons. We got cauldrons stirring themselves left and right over here. Don't know if it's enough to accelerate a little bit here. We need the Arthur really matters more than any lessons. Although I guess you really want to make sure you get to at least 4 so you can be playing the sorry, at least 6 so you can be playing the Unicorn Horn, although you really want 7, right? Because he's going to be trying to play a sickle. So there it is. He did get up to 7. He did play a sickle. the two books, the cauldron and the charm spell. But I'll tell you what, if we see, oh, I don't know, it's gonna return most of his field too. But I was gonna say, if we see Quarrel come down here, and it's like, whoa, reset the whole damn game. Unicorn Horn comes down, be a nut. Davis Finnegan. It's 9:50, so it's gonna be time in the round. Time. All right, I told these guys they can go ahead and just play it out, right? Gotta play it out for the people. I know technically they ran in time, and you know, we're for all things, we're trying to make sure we keep people like we're practicing for a tournament, right? You know, it's not that it's technically a tournament. It's more like your locals, like FNM, but still, you know, you try and keep things going at a pace, right? If we didn't ever have time in the rounds, I'd be here for 5 hours. So I'm just going to go ahead and let these guys play it out. You know, this has been a really exciting best of three, so I'd like to see the end of it. But I would like to see revival rules add like plus three turns or something like that to the end of time once time in the round is called. I try to give players warnings because to me that feels like in other games when time is called and they get those additional turns, getting like a warning ahead of time, like, hey, time's coming up. Basically pretend like you're in turns now. But it is nice to give them a little bit of time to resolve things as it stands in the revival rules for Harry Potter. At the end of time, that's it. All it as it is, and based on the results of the match, whoever's ahead wins, or if both players have won a game, then it's a draw. So technically this would have been a draw for the guys here. But I would like to see the finish it up. I will go ahead and put the results in though for the other table. Sammy taking it 2-0, bludgeoning his opponent to death. I think it is interesting that we saw three Draco lists this week, and the one deck that wasn't Draco was Lucius. In the past few revival events, we have had a super saturation of Quidditch and creature decks, so it was really, really cool to see all these heavy item decks. And again, like I said, I really like Lucius's Cane, So I thought it was really neat to see Lucius Kane coming out. We got to see a little bit of the like the healing loop here that these guys are doing. It's always one of the cool things to do when you're combining charms and potions. I did like seeing that Arthur Weasley was doing his work, doing some pretty serious damage tonight, showing us why he is in the Ministry of Magic. Cracking the nut, gonna go ahead and use Magical Bee, probably get back Ollivander. So we're gonna use Ollivander, we're gonna go get... Wait, why are we looking in the main deck? What? Oh, sorry, we used Magical Me to play Chocolate Frogs. That's my bad. They never, like, I mean, I'm sure they're telling each other the card, but they never, like, highlight the card or pull the card out for us, so we don't know what's going on. So he's going to go and get Quirrell, jam Quirrell into play, and return all the items. So it's going to be two Self-Stirring Cauldrons and a Cane on one side, and on the other side is going to be Sickle, double Magical Me's, a Cauldron, a Lockhart Terror Care Potions, and a Woo Baby and the Unicorn Horn. So just going to go ahead and reset Nicola down to two lessons, but we had the advantage of knowing that we were going to do that and planning for it. So not only do we have four lessons on our side of the table, but we also have the cauldron. So yep, right there, we're going to go ahead and cauldron and put two of those lessons back into the discard pile, and we're going to bring ourselves up to six again and put down the cane to stop our opponent from being able to put the cane down themselves. Oh, excuse me. If you're Frizz, you already have Arthur down, so really what you want to do is your next turn you want to play like a lesson book, and you really want to start just like, okay, three damage with Arthur, and then the next turn after that, like, ramp more. Because actually Draco gives you that action back for the book, so you want to be like lesson book, and then the next turn it's like book something, and then you just need Arthur to be swinging for the fences. So we are going to get Lucius's Kane and Ollivander's with Hannah Abbott. Again, interesting, I think, that we get Lucius's Kane. I think we might be switching out Lucius's Kane for Impersonating Goyle instead. Oh, no, sorry. We're trading Ollivander's and Lucius's Kane from hand. We're getting Impersonating Goyle. And potion our discard pile. Interesting to telegraph your card that far ahead of time. Pretty wild. The Impersonating Goyle. You know, use your Seamus now. Magical Me is coming down, and we're going to have the four lessons there, so we're starting to get to some Arthur territory, and we are going to use an action to deal three damage with Arthur via Magical Me, bringing our opponent to 17. We don't have seven. Oh, yeah, we do. Never mind. Sorry, the cane. So we're going to go ahead and play the sickle here on Morel's side of the field, get that action back. We're going to play Magical Me from our hand. Now we have one action left. But again, I would use Seamus. I would discard two, draw a card. Because you're in a race now, man. Every little bit of burn counts. What do you got for me, guys? Let's see. And we're looping the unicorn horn. We're gonna go ahead and get the unicorn horn, put it discard pile. Magical me is gonna go grab it, do the thing. Oh, sorry, the unicorn horn and the magical me to discard pile were him taking 2 damage from Morel's cane. That's my bad. So Morel did 2 damage at the end of the turn with the cane. Then Nicola is going to slam down a magical me and a charms. And deal 3 with Malfoy again. Or not Malfoy, with Weasley, Mr. Weasley again. Off of one of the books. Another 3. And what's funny is both these guys are able to do so much more, but we're down to a point where we're just like, we're in rags and we're just scrapping for that last loaf of bread, dude. We are just getting real ragtag here. Forget all those fancy plans and all those big plays. We are here chipping away at each other for 3 damage at a time, just trying to get a win. No, the old fist fight equivalent of the end of the game here. So we are going to play a Lockhart's Hair Care Potions, and we are going to play a Severus Snape. And we are going to use Severus Snape straight away. We're healing a bunch of cards. That healing is going to help a lot. Looks like Sickle, Nut, Duster and Cauldron, Ocean, Magical Me, Charms. Ollivanders, and Quirrell. Professor Quirinus Quirrell.
Sedan. What's that got to do with love? Well, this is what he told me. There was this real cute girl, see? She used to go for rides with
How is this Christmas music? And whenever he'd call, it's supposed to be Christmas music playing right now. Open the car door after she got in, there we go.
And he had closed the door. He'd walk around the back of the car to the driver's side, but before he could get there, she would reach over and press the button, locking him out. Then she'd just sit there and wrinkle her nose and grin at him. That's what I think love is.
Oh, how cute. Alright, we've got... Snape is healing now. It's a heal for a heal. This is why time exists, guys. They go in, they get Ollivanders. We get a nut. We get a magical me. We get another one of these. We do the thing. Sammy's probably like, what the hell are you guys doing? As I see him join their voice channel. All right, we got the self-stirring into play. We're back up to a ton of lessons. We're back up to, what, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, we always get to such an absurd number of lessons on this side of the field, but it's because we just keep throwing away our own self-stirring cauldrons, replaying them. So it's going to be Sickle, then we're going to crack a Magical Me. Oh, I think we just did things backwards there. I think we used the Magical Me to get the Sickle, and then we just put the Sickle into play and then cracked the Magical Me. That's fair. Then we played another Magical Me book from our hand. We passed the turn. Nicole is going to go ahead and discard the Christmas piece. Play Christmas piece off the other thing. I'm going to be putting all of these items back into the deck. Yeah, Impersonating Goyle, pretty strong. We're going to go ahead and use it to get rid of Seamus again. Man, it's pretty funny how these late game decks, especially between these two guys... we've deleted our own self-stirring cauldrons and replayed them like twice. We've removed Seamus Finnegan at least twice. Now we're healing using the Unicorn Horn, which makes me think that we either have a Sickle or a Unicorn Horn because we didn't deal damage with Arthur yet. So it looks like we are restoring a two nuts, potion, charm, Ollivanders. Put all that back in there. Shuffle the deck up. 18 to 18. Dude, this is why time exists. We're almost 20 minutes over. Thing is, if you're going to play a deck that is like super late game looping like this, you need to know that's going to take a lot of time and you got to play, you know, accordingly. Then I feel like the bad guy when I got to call time on people. Like they didn't know. Looks like we're gonna go jam our third self-stirring cauldron into play. Use an action to draw a card twice. And with the lack of Seamus Finnegan, that's gonna be just dealing basically how much damage is that? Oh no, what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How the heck did we deal all that? Oh, we had a money that cracked, yeah. Plus the cauldron. Oh, I love that we actually got Seamus into play. That's great. We played our own Seamus, so the old F you, like... You know, I'm not going to let you get that extra action. Because all his extra actions are how he's dealing damage with the cane. We're discarding two to gain an extra action ourselves here. Off of Seamus. I'd like to see us use that. Yeah, we want to Arthur him for 6 and then use the Unicorn Horn. And or Arthur him for 7 if we have a Sickle. We gotta be Arthuring him, though. I mean, I get it. We played the Seamus, and now we're worried about losing, so we'd rather survive. So we played Seamus. We're gonna make another action, use the horn, put all these Sickles back into the deck. I believe we put 2 Sickles on the bottom of the deck is what we did first, right? That's what the Enter does. Now we're gonna crack it.
We're gonna put 6 cards back in the deck. Bunch of long bottoms. This opponent can't do more than 8 damage a turn without Arthur. So we've got Neville, Ollivander's Nut, all the usual suspects. Potions. Another magical me into play for Nicola. Again, it's another. Is that another non-Arthur turn? We gotta be dealing that damage, man. It's a. Oh no. Okay. Good. Good. Oh wait. No. That's a. He moved 7 cards to the main deck. That's him healing. I don't know if we did do the damage. Alright, so then we pass. Morel draws a card from deck, plays a book, plays a lesson. That's got to be the turn, right? That's awesome. That's a hell of a break for Nicola here. We're only going to take 2 damage from the cane. We just told them they're playing round 4. Okay, Nicholas said he just got it. He just won. It's only 20 minutes late. I would really love to know a total count of how many cards would healed. All right, and that's gonna be it for round 3. Sorry if that one was a drug on or was a little slow, or we didn't do as much commentary there, guys. I thought the writing was on the wall pretty quick there, and then time came, and then I thought we were going to be figuring that out sooner, and oh man, I'm just drained. It's the end of the day for me, guys. It's after 10 o'clock at this point. So sorry if this one wasn't as high energy or as informative as the other 2 videos, but at the end, this is a really cool, this is a really cool back and forth between 2 decks with a lot of healing power. What I was saying to these guys is I would love to know how many cards had been healed in total throughout tonight, but especially just in this match, would be really interesting to know, because man, these guys extended the length of the game like by an unnatural amount. But that's going to be it for us this week, guys. Thank you so much for anybody who tuned in, even if it was just for a minute. Or who's watching this later on YouTube on the Dark Mark YouTube channel. Again, if you want to see or read more content, please go to darkmarktcg.com, or you can head over to the harrypottertcg.com website. If you want to join the revival, check us out, join in the Discord, come play in some tournaments with us, and have a great time exploring an old game, guys. But until next time, that's it for us. Ciao.